Welcome to another informative video brought to you by Autruo. In today's video, we will be looking at how a typical labeler machine works. The intricate part will be discussed extensively, coupled with the practical examples. Stay tuned.
Ciao Stefano, sei di nuovo tu. Non hai intenzione di dare un'occhiata a ciò che abbiamo in stock oggi?
Giulia, ho ancora molti di questi articoli in stock a casa mia. Sai, l'ultima volta ho portato questi generi alimentari in eccesso. Magari un'altra volta.
Ho insegnato tanto. Ormai saresti venuto per un rifornimento. Significa che non mangi affatto. Perché quello che hai portato l'ultima volta non è molto. Infatti al mio piccolo Mario non ci vuole una settimana.
Signora, quello è Mario. E il lusso del tempo per cucinare non è così disponibile. Fare la spola tra Napoli e Milano non è facile. E coppia con qualche volo internazionale nel mezzo.
Va bene, amico mio. Spero di vederti presto e puoi sempre essere sicuro che siamo al tuo servizio.
Va bene. Lo farò.
Hi Stefano. What are you up to? Are you going for a shopping?
Not really, Mario. Just taking a walk downtown. With this your handbag. Hope you are not coming from a fashion show.
Nah. Just came to buy some groceries. Stefano. Lest I forget. I drank some bottles before coming here. I saw the labeling works and I want to ask. Is it some handwork? Or how is it done?
Well, it is not a rocket science. Machine designer have devised a perfect machine for this purpose. This machine are usually called labeler in packaging industries. Because by design, it is used to paste label to bottle of all kind. The bottle can be PET or glass bottles. This machine is of different design, but they all have the same working principles. Now let's look at a typical labeling setup on a packaging lines. At the in feed of the labeler, there lies a machine which is known as dryer. The dryer is used to remove moisture from bottles, because it will be very difficult to pass labels on wet bottles, hence it needs. In most setup, electric motors are used for this purpose. Air will be sucked in by the drying machine through the help of electric motor. The sucked air will be heated up by a set of heating element. The already heated air will direct it towards the moving bottle as it passes through the dryer. This ensures that dry bottles reaches the labeler. At the infeed of the labeler lie an electronic sensor. This sensor is of different types. But the most common ones is photoelectric sensor. So basically, when the sensor detects the presence of bottle at infeed, the sensor will send an electric signal to the PLC. With this, the PLC will create a register that will be used to track the encoder pulses. The most common one is clock pulse and high revolution clock pulse. These pulses are different from each other. In some machine design, clock pulse is the number of revolution the machine makes in a specific time, while high revolution clock pulse is the number of pulse available in one revolution. This two pulse will be very handy in a moment. As the machine cam that has the bottle moves towards the labeling areas, because the PLC already knows the position of each cam within the carousel, the PLC will track this cam's moves. This is possible because the high revolution pulse of that specific cam is known when bottles enters the machine. for conservation's sake and in order to minimize cost and to make the environment clean. Machine designer have designed the labeling areas in such a way that label will not be picked until the bottles to be label is in position. Now let it sink. Once the bottle to be label is not within the machine carousel or not in position, the label issues will not lock into the label tray. However, when the bottles is in position, the shoes lock into the tray and the bottles will be labeled.
All right. If I may ask, the movement of the tray is achieved through the use of what? Can you try to explain a little bit?
Most machine designer uses pneumatic cylinder to move the label trays to and fro. In the case of this designer, valve terminal were used. As the PLC send digital signals when the bottle is in basic position. The electronic part of the valve terminals interprets this signal accordingly, and the valve terminal switches, thereby allowing compressed air to get to the tray cylinder. Again, if you want to learn how valves terminals works, kindly check my previous series on that. A detail and practical explanations were made. Now let look at how the gripper was designed. The gripper consists of a finger and soft materials. As the gripper rotates, the label will be picked from the shoes after the label has transferred. The finger will clip and hold the label in place as it rotates along. When it reaches the bottles, the finger opens and the label will be placed on the bottles. The opening and closing of the finger is achieved in two ways, which are by location and two pairs of hole on the rotating disc. As the ball rotates within, the finger will be clip in position. However, when the ball suddenly enter the holes, the finger opens and allow exchange of label either between the shoes or the bottles.
So if I am not mistaken, the opening and closing of the finger is done mechanically. The path in which the roller rotates within is held stationary, while the hole on the disc are designed and located at the shoe side for label picking and at the carousel for label transfer. Impressive pieces of engineering. Now, if I may ask, the conveyor system, how does it move in synchronization with the machine? I mean, when the machine is at low speed, the conveyor also moves very slowly. Likewise, when the machine is at high speed, the conveyor also moves very fast in order to meet up. Because if this features is not there, it is either we have less bottle at in feed or bottle jam at in feed or at the discharge conveyor.
Well, you are right to some extent. Conveyor synchronization with the lead machine, as it is usually called by the machine designer. This is done in order to forestall less bottles and to prevent bottle jam. The engineering behind this lies within the positioning device. Not only that, the encoder are used for bottle tracking, the rotational speed of the machine, which is RPM of the machine, can also be gotten through the encoder. This means, apart from the fact that the encoder signal is transmitted to the machine PLC, the signal are also shared with external machine. And in this case, we are dealing with a conveyor system. The signal sent to this machine will be used by the PLC of the conveyor system to either speed up the conveyor in relation to the lead machine or vice versa.
So if the lead machine is idle, the conveyor will also stop moving?
No. This depends on the machine designer. Some designer will ramp down the speed of the conveyor in such a way that after some time it stop moving, while some will have a rapid conveyor stop. That is, the machine will ramp until the conveyor stop moving.
Okay. On a final note, how do we checkmate poor labeling? Because there are room for such. even when is not from the machine. How about if it is material related?
Machine designer usually incorporates sensor technology for this. During commissioning, labeling samples are brought in as a template. It is with this that the sensory system will be programmed on. So the ones that does not conform with the programmed spec will be rejected. Now let's do a quick recap. We started off looking at how labeling machine works. The function of dryer was discussed extensively. From there, we look at how positional device are used to track bottle to be labeled. We also looked at how gripper works. The opening and closing of finger was discussed extensively. From there, we look at how conveyors are synchronized with the leading machine, and finally, we ended off looking at how sensor are used to track bottles that does not conform to standard. Hope you have learned something today. See you in the next one.